Welcome to Jeddah, the second city of Saudi Arabia.
Yeah, and it's a major cosmopolitan city. It's a huge seaport.
Yep, that's the Red Sea behind us right there.
Yeah, and it's the gateway to the two most holy places in Islam, Mecca and Medina.
So you get a lot of international people come here. Also a lot of tourists from Saudi Arabia as well.
Yes.
It's a really interesting place to look around. We're going to be here for a week. We're couch surfing here, so that'll be interesting. Today we're going to wander up and down the Corniche, aren't
yes.
we, Mandy?
Yeah. It's surprisingly cloudy. I mean, I know it's winter, but Jeddah's like, it's a lot hotter than Riyadh. Like, for example, we left Riyadh and it was about 9 degrees.
Yeah.
Got here and it was like 22, and it's going to be like 31 later in the week. So it's
a pleasant January day.
Yeah. But check out the clouds behind us.
Yes, and the Red Sea. And life down at the Corniche. This time of day, it's quite quiet, I think. A lot of people come out over here late in the evening, but people are walking around, strolling, enjoying the promenade.
Yeah.
It's
so fun. Even with the building noise in the background, because, man, there's a lot of buildings going up here, so much construction work.
Let's check out the Corniche a little bit more. We spent 14 hours on a bus yesterday coming here from Riyadh, so it's really nice to be outside in the fresh air, even though it's a bit cloudy out there. It's nice to be by the Red Sea. Okay, first fascinating discovery, we can't help ourselves. I don't know what we thought this was, a bench, but it says mobile carpet, that's the only thing in English, and there's a handle on the side.
Oh, it suddenly just came out from underneath.
Maybe there's a carpet in there that you can rent to have a picnic on. We're going to have to ask somebody.
Yeah, or it could be a prayer mat. That would be my other thought. When you turn the handle, just there was something happening.
Something rolling around inside, yeah. we've got to find out.
Still looking at the food kiosk, but there are loads of these little candy stores around. This one's Sea of Candy, and they've got popcorn and slushies and other things. So just walking further along up by the Mövenpick Resort, and look at this sign. Oh my word, you have been warned. Violators shall be punished if you swim here. So I wouldn't risk it. So there are toilet blocks all along the Corniche, and like, we were really happy about that. We thought, yay, you know, that's pretty cool. We just went and asked, there's this big like gate turnstile at the front of the toilet, and it turns out it actually costs 10 rial. I don't know if you buy some sort of card or ticket, and that gets you in four times. So it's 2 rial 50 to use the toilet along the Corniche. So obviously we're going to be looking for a free option. In case you don't know or aren't aware, in Saudi Arabia, as with other Muslim countries, there are always toilets in the mosques. So, you know what I mean? If you are busting to go, look out for a mosque and you'll be able to go there. And the lovely thing here, they also provide free water, free drinking water. So strange, like the restaurants along here, that was the Herfies. I'm not too sure what this one is, but they've all sort of been abandoned, and I don't know if they're going to be under reconstruction or torn down or what, but quite a contrast to all the new buildings going up. So there's one of the stalls with prices coming down. So water is 2, popcorn is 5, and tea 3, Arabic coffee 7. So happy that there's a Jeddah sign. Yay, we haven't come across one of these for ages. We've got the obligatory selfie, and look at it. It's actually really nice. What do you think, Lee?
I like it.
Yay, Jeddah. So there are several vending machines along the way. Now the only issue is they accept Mada only. Mada must be a Saudi Arabian card, I think. It's not Visa, not MasterCard. We've actually had a bit of trouble using our Visa card lately. So I think if they are aiming for 100 million tourists a year by 2030, maybe they should get the system fixed a little bit so Visa and MasterCard are widely available, not just Mada. So something we've really noticed about the Middle East, and maybe Saudi Arabia in particular, is the love of like American fast food. So we've been like trying to find some local stuff along the Corniche, and the two places that are doing the best trade are Baskin Robbins and Dunkin' Donuts.
So this is Corniche Beach. It looks the most developed part. They've got the palm trees and some nice sand. A lot of detritus washed up, unfortunately. That could do with a cleanup, but it looks like it could be a nice place. It's all locked off now, unfortunately, I'm afraid.
So here we have a green sign So yes, this is a swimming area. Make sure you see the flag before swimming. Look at the colour of the water.
That's beautiful, doesn't it? Only yeah. Would you get access.
But yeah, there's no way in, is there?
No, it was locked up back there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, we did look for a supermarket, we couldn't find one, could we?
Bit of a fail, yeah. And a lot of the food places are closed or they're still being built or stuff like that, so there wasn't a lot of options. And we went for Albike again.
Yes, we said we weren't going to, but hey, this is actually the home place of Albike.
Yeah, so...
it seemed appropriate.
Any room?
We got, we made a bit of a mistake, we didn't get the falafel meal, it was just a plain falafel, still with two tahini. And we've got hummus and a bread roll, and for coleslaw for the healthy option.
Yeah.
We've gone for an egg and cheese sandwich.
That looks pretty good.
There was five. Lee's got a chicken sandwich for seven, because today, for some reason, there was no like fried food. And yeah. This bun, I don't know what that goes with, it goes with something. Now, we had to buy water. We don't normally like buying water, do we?
Yeah.
And it's Nestle. I know, yuck. But unfortunately, the desalination water here.
You can't drink the tap water, apparently, so we're sticking with bottled water. Hopefully this is going to be enough to keep us going. If not, we'll look for another supermarket. Wow, and look at this part. This is Copacabana. What do you think, Mandy?
Interesting. When you think that the Corniche is like Jeddah's premier beach tourist spot, and Jeddah is potentially Saudi's premier tourist city, it's quite, it's a little bit neglected, shall we say.
Yeah, it needs a bit of work, doesn't it? Yeah.
Quite a bit of tidying up.
Yeah.
Checked out the trash.
Yeah, it's a bit unfortunate, the old trash situation down there.
Really sad.
Little things like that definitely need to be improved upon, don't they?
And this is like a really modern looking sort of promenade area where I think people buy their drinks, their Starbucks, etc., and come along and enjoy them.
Yeah, by the water. Pretty
lovely.
Nice.
Kind of looks like the beach over there, yeah. But not really. People are just sort of, oh yeah, they're sitting and enjoying. And it's lovely how clean the water is. This area doesn't look quite so mucky. It's very nice. So along behind the Corniche, there are some beautiful properties. I mean, look at this one. Look at the garden. Wow, it's just absolutely stunning. And we did notice the fact that, I don't know if you can see in the distance, is that high wall that stops the neighboring property looking over. So maybe they've even got a pool or something.
We've come to the end of the day and everybody's down here now having their little picnics and sitting along the waterfront. It's really quite pleasant, actually. Got a nice vibe to it. I like it.
Yeah, the clouds have been pretty impressive all day, haven't they?
Yeah, it really feels like it's going to hammer it down with rain any minute, but it hasn't. So we've got our jumpers on now though, so there you go. Still not that warm.
Yeah. Isn't it incredible, Lee, the TV screen?
That is so impressive. Yeah, wow. The quality.
Wow.
They're giving away free cleaning products.
Very
lovely. Thank you so much.
Let's shut
them to our
so
house.
Lovely.
Hello,
hello. Wonderful.
Just what I needed.
So this is the Fakir Aquarium. Apparently they have like dolphin shows, etc. Families only. No single men, as per the park rules. Okay, we've seen what I think is officially the most frightening ride ever. Oh my word. A million times no. What do you think, Lee? Would you do it?
That doesn't really appeal to me too much, to be honest. I think I'd rather have a cup of tea and a biscuit. On a mission for food again, and we found this place, Falafel Abu Ramzi. And it was really confusing. Everything's in Arabic, it's really local. Luckily two guys helped explain things, but it still got confusing at the counter when we paid. But we've ordered, what's this, the large shawarma?
It's a large shawarma.
Yeah, so typical shawarma, all cut up into pieces. With chips, fries.
So you forgot the pickles.
Yeah,
so...
and that's just come after Mandy asked.
Yeah, gently reminded them.
And we've also ordered khabsa, which is a traditional Saudi Arabian rice and chicken.
Yeah.
And that's coming soon, so we'll show you that when it arrives. But
yeah.
Until now.
And in total it was 31 real and five.
31 real.
Lee, how is it?
I just tried this sauce. I don't know what it is, but it almost made my eye water. It's pretty hardcore. I did say there was going to be some five doors, and they weren't wrong.
So what's this now?
And this is what their kabsa looks like. There's a quarter of chicken underneath there, with rice, and these interesting looking sauces.
Some onion and some lemon.
Wow. That's got a kick to it, the green one.
Okay.
And I'm assuming these are the same. That's nice, just mild.
Okay.
Gravy kind of thing.
And the rice kind of looks like a biryani. How is it?
Really good, steaming hot, fresh out of the oven, yeah. Healthy, good value, happy.
So it's really delicious, the kabsa, the chicken and rice. It has just this lovely clove flavour. Now he forgot to give us our drink, so I went up and asked. And he ended up giving us two. So yay, gotta be...
cola.
Yeah.
Saudi Arabian speciality.
Definitely. Yeah. But you've got to be proactive, but really flavoursome. And I think we've actually got way too much food.
Yeah, we might be taking some home.
Yeah, it would be brilliant. Our wonderful couch surfing host Mo has brought us breakfast. It's so lovely. There are three types of bread here. This one looks like a plain type. I think this one might be cheese stuffed. And this one looks as though it might have sweet potato or pumpkin in. Not too sure, but we'll add the names. And there are also two different types of beans. Now, we've had fool before, but these are different types. And like, I love the green chili on top of that one. And here's another type here. And they come with olive oil. And Mo had told me you put the olive oil on if the beans get a bit dry. So like, what a wonderful, healthy way to start the day. So it turns out this one here is the cheese one. It looks so lovely. And I'm going to try the beans now. Wow, it's like tomato-y. Mmm. Delicious, light and tomato flavoured. This one here. It's a lovely vegetable curry. Well, lightly curried vegetable, but delicious. But yeah, I think this is going to be like a wonderful feast.
This is Mo, and he's brought us to a South Indian restaurant, and we're going to try some traditional South Indian food. He's going to talk us through it, Mo.
Yeah, so we have nothing fancy here. We just have a mutton biryani. Biryani is like pretty common. Everybody knows what a biryani is.
Mm-hmm.
And the other thing is, this is a thali. This is like a crispy, what do you call it, papadam?
Papadam, yeah.
Yes. Uh-huh. You have some flatbreads and you have like different curries. Yeah. You have like different curries and different dips.
Oh, wonderful.
You just take it and then you just eat it with different dips.
Excellent.
It's called a thali. Thali basically means a plate. So you have a plate with different curries and different dips. So, bon appetit.
Fantastic.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Awesome. And do you actually say like bon appetit in... which Indian language do you speak? Do you speak?
I speak Urdu.
Yeah. And is there anything in Urdu for bon appetit?
I don't know. No, I don't think so.
Because not in English either. We say bon appetit.
Enjoy your food. Bismillah.
Yeah. Bismillah. Yeah. Exactly. Bismillah.
Yeah. They're different types of like spiciness or
So this is like what I got, a veg thali. So there's nothing special about it.
Yeah.
All are like veg curries, dips. If I would have ordered a mutton thali or a chicken thali, then you would have an additional curry, which would have chicken or mutton in it.
Yeah.
But everything else would be the same. So you have bread here, you can eat it. Once you're out of bread, you can ask for more.
Yeah.
You can also get some extra rice.
Excellent.
People also would like to eat it with rice. This is also a drink. I mean,
Okay. Like a soup?
Yeah, like a soup thing, but it's not hot. It's savory. It's not sour. It's a little bit savory.
Can I drink it like this? Or
yeah. Like it, and then you can tell us what is it.
Oh, lovely. Yeah. It's a bit salty.
It's like laban.
It's kind of nice. Yeah, similar. Yeah. It's like a fermented something.
Okay. And what are these two small dishes here?
Well, this is nothing but yogurt salad. Let us say.
Yeah. Raita.
Raita. Exactly.
Okay. Wonderful. Love raita.
And this would be, I think, something that you eat with biryani. A small curry with eat with biryani, which. In Hyderabad, in a Hyderabad restaurant, you would say mirchi ka salan, which basically means curry of pepper.
Okay.
Nice. That's a literal translation, but I don't know if this is the same thing. But
yeah. Let's tuck in and see what
delicious.
It's like.
Delicious.
Come back to the South Indian restaurant that we came to yesterday because it's so good. And look at this, what we can have for breakfast here. This is the dosa.
Masala dosa.
Masala dosa. It's got potato inside it.
Yes,
that's
look at that.
8 or 9.
That was real. 8, yep.
Yeah, and these are...
It's a puri, 3-piece set.
They're so beautiful.
I think they're like
puffy,
donutty things.
Yeah.
And they come with like 2 different types of curry.
And that's 8.
Yep, that was 8.
Yeah.
And of course, karak chai. Yeah, so in total it should be 20. And this comes
it's
with...
really tasty flavours there. Wow. This is a great breakfast.
Because we're not used to South Indian flavours and...
Lovely fresh and delicious. But enjoy this.
Look at oh, this is beautiful. It's like a crepe or something.
Mm. Wow. Amazing.
So one of the things we've noticed about Saudi, the population here is about 75% expats. So workers from all around the world and a lot are from the Indian subcontinent, which is why you get such delicious food. And this Southern Indian, South Indian cuisine is amazing. Like, curry for breakfast. Well done, Lee. You're doing very well. Because normally you wouldn't have that.
I'm stepping out of my comfort zone, aren't I?
But these are the kind of like not sweet donuts. And they go so well with the delicious potato curry and the other veggie curry. And I'm wondering if these ones here on the masala dosa are to represent the colours of the Indian flag. That's my theory anyway. I could be completely wrong. But it's just really tasty, fresh and delicious.